Morning. So, I wasn't gonna record today. I'm picking up hay bales out west of our farm, and this is where the bridge is getting put together, which it's not a bridge, it's actually gonna be a big old tube. And there's just so much action going out on around here that I'm gonna have to record a little bit. I'm just moving all the bales, gathering them all into one spot, and then he went with me all the way, really far away out west, in our new spot that we just did this year for the first time. We picked up the bales out there. There's 12, so he hauled 10, and I carried two bales over here to this farm. Now I'm just putting them all in a nice row so that he can drive in between. I can load them up real fast. And Aiden had been out here to gather them up, so that's what I'm doing while he's going to unload. But wasn't going to record today, but there's so much interesting stuff, and I got so many questions to ask you guys when it comes to building or preparing to put a tube in the ground for a road. So I'm going to record a little bit of what they're doing, and I'll do a little bit of what I'm doing, and hope you guys enjoy it. So right now, there's a few bales back here that I gotta grab. It's nice. I got the loader back on so I can grab them all at one time, which you have already seen me load up the trailer and all that stuff in the last video, but we are farther away now, so Jared's hauling them all in, and I'm gathering these all up. This is the only field that Aiden hasn't gathered the bales up in. Oh, this is gonna be a pain to spike. Yay. This ain't gonna work. I gotta move it forward. Should have picked this bale in front of me up with the 3-point. So now that I'm on better ground, spike it down lower. Sorry for the bad angle. Here we go. That'll work. That'll make it. But anyways, a few bales back here. There's pretty scattered out on this farm, so it is going to take me a little while to gather them all together. Yeah, I'm still having a transmission fault. I'm still moving, so it's fine. Corn's looking good. We got a little sprinkle this morning, so we didn't start very early when it came to doing this type of stuff. I learned some more about that Honda Pioneer, and since it's a higher trim level, it's a double clutch. That's why it shifts smoother than the one we have. So, our older one. We need names for those, but both are Honda Pioneers. If you watch my channel for a little bit, I need some pretty good duo names for both of them. I need some names fast. So here's what we got going on. We got a guy that just delivered tons of wood, and then there's this crane thing. And that's really what I was questioning. What is the purpose of this crane? It's the one with the box on it. It doesn't have like pallet forks or anything, I don't think. Maybe it does. Maybe I'm just dreaming or something, but something's not right, and I don't know. I mean, we're not inside. Sorry, I'm trying to hide that I'm recording them. I mean, it's nothing they can do, but I don't understand why you need something that puts people up in the air to build or to put together a tube in the ground. Doesn't make sense to me, but anyways, I'm just gonna keep moving hay bales around. I got them all nice and lined up. So, I have some big questions about that. I don't know that much about building bridges or putting in a big old tube for a road to go over, but why do you need a basket to put people up in the air? I guess if you were building a bridge, I'd make more sense, because you maybe put that thing underneath the bridge and maybe you're welding or bolting stuff together. But I'm pretty sure this one's getting a tube put in. There's two different places that are getting new getting worked on. One's getting a bridge and one's getting a tube here on this road. So that's why we're picking up these bales and bringing them home real fast at the moment, because of we don't want that other one to close, because if the other one closes, it's going to be really hard to get back here. So we're rounding them all up. That other bridge is supposed to start from a different company sometime next week. So that's why we're rounding all the bales up and getting them brought home, so we don't have to mess with them. They come out here with a brush hog and brush hog the road banks and stuff and get it all where we don't have to see this thing for quite some time, because it's going to be a while before they get everything wrapped up around here. So let me know what that is used for when it comes to building. I mean, if it's a bridge, it kind of makes more sense. I'd understand that. So this might be the bridge one. I'm not 100% sure, but I'm 99% sure that this one was supposed to be the one with the tube. I swear it was, but I could be wrong. I don't see any bridge parts there, so I don't know. I really don't know. Or that wood, that wood's getting used to line up, kind of put up against the walls that enter towards the pipe, and helps the water flow go to the pipe. And then it makes it easier for them to stack them if they have that crane. Yeah, that makes more sense. No, it still doesn't. I really don't know. I don't know why you can't just use your skid steer. I don't know. If you know, leave it in the comments below. I'm just picking up hay bales. There's not much for me to do besides talk. I mean, this is very PUD work at the moment, honestly. Oh yeah, and I stole my brother's Prime drink. Out of all the drinks, this is the only one I like. It's the ice pop one. Yeah. Other than that, I don't have that much to talk about besides my curiosity about that bridge. Doesn't make any sense. Here we go. Where are they going to unload that truck? I think they might have took the skid steer back. I don't know, but there's the crane right there. I don't understand it. Doesn't make sense to me. I don't know, but nothing's moving at the moment, so I don't know what they're up to. They're discussing their strategies. Maybe they need another crane. Yeah, probably. An ice cream truck. Which, not gonna lie, if an ice cream truck shows up, I'm definitely gonna see if I can get some ice cream from it. But I don't know what they're doing. I don't know. I need to work for one of them companies for like a day. See how it is. Oh, they're all standing in their trailer. Talking. Circle. Working hard. Yeah. I really can't say that much. I'm not working that hard either. I'm sitting in an AC tractor cruising back and forth. I've got enough bales. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 7 or 8. I have enough bales to fill Jared up almost twice. And I'm just cruising back and forth. I really want to get them all over here so I can know how many trips it's going to take for him to get them all, and if how many extras we're gonna have, and how many I need to put on his trailer each time he comes over here to maximize efficiency. But I don't know if I'm gonna beat him to come back or not. He was pulling it with the tractor. I could definitely beat him and round them all up, but he's got the mini semi on it. Sorry, making some weird noises. But yeah, this is actually the farm that I got my two-row planter from. I don't know why it was unhooked where it was, but it's 80 years old, so who knows? There's probably a house or something here a long time ago. I'll show you kind of where it came from. So here's the wonderful trees, and right down that, right in that little hole right there, there was a big enough gap a month ago that I could fit the tractor back in there. You can kind of see down there now. But that goes all the way to, there's corn on the other side that's planted there. And there's actually a nice little place where there's no trees or no nothing. And that's where that two-row planter was sitting. And I crawled through that little gap right there because the corn was already planted. And I picked it up with this thing, which I have a video of that. There's actually a playlist on my YouTube channel that if you want to go check it out on how I got that whole thing running and operating. These are the last two bales, or am I going to have one random sitting around that corner? We will find out. Stay tuned. Here, I'll record me doing this. This is some hard work. Boom. Boom, boom, boom. I'll get that bale. Yeah. I dropped the 3-point all the way down because this one is pretty much, we unscrewed the things where it's pretty much set where it needs to be, the two links. Reverse, please. Thank you. Shake your camera. Yep. Boom. Wow. Unless I'm really unfortunate. This is gonna be nice. Nice. That is nice. Look at that. No extra bales. Oh, we're about to hit a hole. But yeah, that's nice. There's still one more patch I gotta go grab tons of bales from. There's actually a lot of bales over there. But yeah. Oh, they're working. I wish I could hold the camera more level. But I'm not wanting to stop. I guess that big old excavator is unloading everything. So I'm gonna get back to work. I'll record a little bit of them. So when it comes down to this Prime drink, I'm not a supporter of the people that support the drink. But whenever I open the fridge in the morning and the only drink that's in there is four of those, I had to grab one. So, yeah, I'm not a big supporter of the beliefs of the people that support this brand. But, yeah, I mean, there's a few things that I agree with them, but there's quite a bit that I disagree with them. So, just wanted to put that out there. So everybody knows. And when it comes to that drink also, I'd rather have a Code Red Mountain Dew instead of that. That, it's not the best thing in the world. I mean, I guess you could say it's good because it doesn't have calories in it. It has 20 calories. That's good, I guess. But yeah, I take a Gatorade since this is a kind of a, supposed to be a hydration drink. So I'd take a Gatorade over it any day. Any flavor of Gatorade. And there's a lot of flavors that I don't like in Gatorade. So it's not bad, but it's not good. I mean, it's better than Diet Pops. Any Diet Pop. I don't like Diet Pops. They don't taste good at all. They're junk. Just junk. Well, see, that's a poopy entrance. It's muddy. And I don't go up that. We go all terrain, and I go up this way. Why? Because that will get my tractor muddy, and it'll make it where I gotta clean it. Windows need clean. I need to come up here with the brush hog and at least get that dang little tree there and all those. I don't know. I haven't done that for a year or two, but yeah, there's quite a few bales up in this nice little chunk here. Yeah, nice haze right here, so yep, gotta bring them all out because Jared can't get in here with the mini semi, so I take them all up the road a little ways and drop them off. So that's why I don't think I'm gonna beat him when it comes to him coming back. If I do, I get to ride home with him, and yeah, maybe I can get lunch or something, because that'd be nice. Well, their trucks are leaving to deliver their goods. All of those boards are off to the side. I wonder what the heck they're for. I don't know. But Jared's already taken one load. It's going to be about three loads, and I only got two more bales to wind up, so he should be getting close to being on his way back. I don't know. Yeah, it won't take me very long, so I'll probably ride back with him because I'm all done with bringing them all together. The only places we got left out here is the waterways. So, yeah. I picked up, so yesterday I made a video and I picked up around 100 bales on the main farm. So, that's all we've had picked up so far. So, everything else has been stacked off to the side by my brother. So, yep. This is our nice little entrance into this place. See, I don't have traction right now. And yeah, there we go. Need to get those dang trees. But yep, all the way in the back are my two bales I got left. Well, I'm waiting. All the bales lined up and let's see, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19. 19. So that means two loads. One's gonna have 10, one's gonna have 9. So, yep. They are working. So, yep. They're putting up, so that wood stuff. Oh shoot. Let's say this is the where the pipe is. They're going like angling the water into the pipe on both sides. Or when it enters and exits. So yeah. That's what the boards are for, I guess. At least that's what it looks like over the mountain. So I'm just waiting. We are loaded once again. All the bales are gone. We're packing out. They are officially, oh, it's really blurry, sorry. But they are officially got those boards put on the up two sides of the bridge, so that's nice. I think it's gonna be a bridge. Me and Jared were thinking about it. It's probably gonna be a bridge. That's probably why that box loader thingy bajigger is here. So, yeah. On to the waterways, and then that'll be it for out here picking up hay bales. Need to come out here and do some brush hogging up against the road, make it look pretty. But other than that, all done. Well, I have hauled 8 loads since I picked up the camera. This video is going to be pretty long anyways, so I guess I'll record me picking up and loading up this last load. We're back close to the farm, so I don't need Jared. This was this big old patch right here. Quite a bit of hay bales on it, so, yep. It's only took me 2.5 hours. So, yeah, it's pretty close to home. Yeah. I am very tired. It's hot. Whenever you go from AC tractor for a few minutes and then you hop into a very hot truck that doesn't get any cooler because it doesn't have AC, and I don't go faster than 25 miles an hour driving back and forth because it's literally down the road, just on top of the hill over there. So, then I hop in a skid steer that's really hot, and then it finally cools off, but then I gotta get out of it by that time. So,
Yeah.
If you're new around here, subscribe, stick around, because I make farming content. And if you watch this much of the video, you must like what's going on in it. So, yeah. If you're a returning subscriber, leave your thoughts and comments down below, and leave a like. It means a lot. It actually helps push my content to other people, so please leave a like. So, yeah. So this is my loader control. This is my lever to flip from forward to reverse. So I pull it up, forward, and then lower and line up my spikes with the bale. And then I tilt back on my bucket and I lift up. And then down like that or in reverse. I sit in B5 at about 1400 RPMs. It's fast and it's also very gentle. And it doesn't work the tractor very hard whenever I'm using the clutch a lot. So. I squeeze a bale right between these two. And I pretty much repeat the process I just did on the opposite side. Boom. Hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you guys did, leave a like, leave a comment, and yeah, I'll see you guys in the next one.